I've been with Bright Cove, my company, for 4.5 years, but I'm new to this community, and I'm really excited to be here. I think everything I've heard so far about the partners, the clients, the customers you guys work with, I think there's a really nice fit for including video and some of the technologies out there to be part of that. So with that, I'm here today to talk about video, to talk about best practices all around content marketing. So what are the challenges we see in the market today? What do we recommend? What do our customers do? And then back that with a lot of research and statistics that we've gathered from frequent questions that we typically get from our customers. My name is Cassandra Zuffante. I am the Director of Partners at Bright Cove. So I work primarily with agencies, system integrators, and our resellers that resell our Bright Cove product. Out of curiosity, how many people in this room know about Bright Cove or have heard of Bright Cove before? Okay, good. So a nice show of hands, but some people are new. So Bright Cove is an online video platform. That's our flagship product. We focus on giving you all the tools you need to publish professional video content to the web. That's it. It's pretty simple, but when you dig into the back-end system, there's a lot of complexity, and there's a lot of features and functionality that we provide on top of that. Everything from monetization to the encoding piece to live streaming, we power all of that for you, so it becomes very simple for you to work with video. But today, again, I'm going to showcase some of the customers that we work with. We have about 5,500 customers around the world that use Bright Cove. You have absolutely used our technology before. You probably just don't know it. So it's I'll use some of those customers to showcase what we do, but I'm not here to talk about Bright Cove. I'm here just to talk about video. So with that, with the hope that technology works, I do want to start off by showing a quick video from our friends at Adobe that I think really pinpoints some of the challenges that we see as marketers and how to get that content strategy to work. So pay close attention to the end, and let's see what you think.
Peter, come take a look at this.
Mr. Daniels.
Look at this.
What's this? The numbers, they keep getting bigger and bigger.
The clicks are off the charts.
Yeah.
Yoshi, it's Walter. We're back.
Yes, sir!
Everything you got on Whip Pulp right now.
He really loves that thing.
So I think based on the reaction, it's a pretty common challenge that we see, right? You know, the first thing they say is the clicks are off the charts, right? How do we track these clicks? What does a click mean? What is the actual value that we're trying to find in terms of our content? You know, what is important to us? Is it to actually buy a product? Is it to call us? Is it to download a white paper? There's a million things in which us as content marketers are trying to track. But it's really difficult to do that today. So we look at this as the engagement challenge, right? Everybody is connected, and they are connected all the time, whether it's at home, whether it's at work, whether it's shopping, as we just heard at the last session, right? So people are always connected. They always have their eyes and ears to your content. But you have to make sure that you have something that stands out and actually catches them and engages with them. Now, the challenge is that if you had to guess what the adult attention span is today, I think that you'd probably assume it's a bit more than 12 seconds. Now, in 2002, the attention span was 12 seconds. That's not a lot of time. What's disappointing to find out is that today, we're down to 8 seconds. So the average adult gives you 8 seconds of attention before they want to move on to something else because of this connection, because there's too many things that are happening. What's even more shocking to find out is that a goldfish actually has an attention span of 9 seconds. Now, I don't know how they found that research, but to understand that we have a lower attention span than a goldfish is something that, as a marketer, you have to consider. How are you going to grab their attention so that they take the next step? On top of that, we also know that the buyer journey has changed. This isn't news to a lot of us. We just heard how, you know, shopping for a suit, the first thing you might do is actually look online, right? So 70% of your decision-making process is now made before you actually buy a product. Do you have a question? Just attention span in general. The question was, is the attention span for adults, is it just for video or is it for all content? So it's all content. Because if you think about it, you're on your device, you're looking at Facebook, you move on, everything is short these days. And so going back to the buyer decision-making process, everything you do around your content is very important, because before anybody will engage with your brand, they've already gone to your website, they've gone to your social media, they've read reviews, and they've spoken to their friends about this. So that by the time they actually call you, they probably know what they want. They've checked prices, they understand what that product is. So what this means is that your content is more important than ever. Right now, your content is the most important asset that you have in terms of getting your message across and getting your brand across. This needs to be consistent across channels. You need to understand who your audience is, and you need to make sure that that content is engaging so that you can pull that user in. You really have to start thinking of your content as your first sales call. The first time I visit your website, if I'm not impressed, I'm gonna go somewhere else, right? The first time I see a video that's gone viral or shared, if I don't like that, I'm not gonna re-engage with your brand. So you have to think of this as really not your first, but your second and your third sales call, because people will continue to revisit before they actually do something or take an action. This isn't like the past where you would go into a store, you would feel the products, you would actually speak to a sales rep before making a decision. You already know what you want, or you think you know what you want before you do that. The bigger problem is that if you go to the web and you try and get your content out there, we know that people are completely overwhelmed with what's out there and what they can find. When you look at B2B content, for example, up to 70% of that content doesn't even get used. If I look at Bright Cove and our website alone, we have blog posts and case studies and white papers, and we are just overwhelming our users with our newsletter and the continuous content that we have. How do you sift through that to make sure the relevant content gets to the right places? This is a huge challenge. And we know that our customers are screaming for help. They are drowning in all of the content that's out there, and you need to help guide them to the right place. The good news is that video is a type of content that helps you get there. Video is a type of content that allows you to really engage with your audience and tell your message. Now, I'm going to share an equation that our global VP of marketing has put together that I understand this is the simplest equation you'll probably see, and it will hopefully not bring you back to your school days, but we really believe that the right content in the right place at the right time is all you need. Sounds simple, right? This isn't something that's hard to do. But really, if you focus on ensuring that you have all of these three things together, and you put video content everywhere, and you're updating your content everywhere, this is something that's easy to do. Now, working with systems like Typo3 that allows you to easily add and change content for any of your customers, this is a challenge that can be accomplished. Now, when you integrate video content into that mix, we know that this is one of the most effective ways in which you can actually track and record marketing results. These are some statistics from different case studies, and I do point out that whenever I show statistics, I understand that these have to be relevant to what your customer or what you are trying to accomplish as a business. But some of our case studies have proven that by adding video content, you're increasing search. The way in which Google actually tracks, the algorithm it uses to track video content, ranks video content higher than it does text, allowing you, if you follow the best practices in Google Sitemaps, when you add video content, it allows you to rank higher on Google search. It also improves the time on site. If people are engaging with video content and they want to actually engage with your brand, there's relevant content and video portals that can keep people there, they're likely to stay longer on your site and view more content. And then lastly, this conversion that we're already hearing a lot about today. You know, whatever it is that you're using to track conversion, you can have an increase by having the right best practices around video with calls to action and with other data around that. 105%, and I'll walk through that specific case study in a little bit so you can actually see some of these. These are obviously, again, they're statistics relevant to specific customers we see. Adding video content to your site is not going to give you these results just like that, right? We have to implement these best practices, which I'll showcase in just a bit, in terms of what our clients do to get results like these. And you know, the point here is more that each of these, no matter how small that percentage is, if I have any marketers in this room that are responsible for the data that you collect from your website, it's a really tough job to sit there and look at data, whether it's email open rates, how many visitors you have, how many page views that they saw. A percentage increase of about 1% is huge for a lot of organizations. So to see any type of shift in terms of what these statistics looks like can have a big impact on your brand and on your site. The other good news is that when we look at the content on the web, video is increasing. So this is a study that we did with a content marketing institute. So they were interviewing CMOs. So this is really coming from an internal marketing perspective. All of these are third-party white papers that you can download from our website. So we try and collect data from outside vendors so that our statistics are coming from another source. But really what they show is that video content is where the budget is going. There is knowledge about this. So I don't think it's new to any of you that video is something you want to consider using. It's just a matter of shifting it and finding the budget for it. But what about your audience? This is, you know, internally we know that there's improvements that it can have to your actual site and your user interface, but what is your audience actually saying about content? So we recently completed some research that we had a survey that we worked with a third-party vendor to complete with us. It's a global audience. We had 2,000 responses where the focus was around brand content and the perceived messages around brand content. This is the first survey that we've done like this where we really want to track how people respond to branded content. So not necessarily advertisements, but going to Hugo Boss's website and watching that content, what do you feel to the content that they own? And the biggest finding that we found was that 76% of those people preferred to watch video content. So your customers and your end clients are now telling you they want video content. This is the type of content they want to consume. A quarter of those people also thought that this was the most trusted type of content they could consume. So why would people trust video content? There's a few different reasons that we listed here, but you know, the two that stick out to me the most are that they find it appealing and they find it engaging. It's easy to watch content, it's easy to consume this content, and it's something that we as a generation are now starting to shift and we're starting to look at, and we expect it to be there. So your users go to a website, they expect at some point they'll find video content there today. And then lastly, when we talked, we asked a bit more deeper into what is their response once they actually complete video content that they liked or they enjoyed and that potentially they shared. These responses, I think, are quite significant, right? So they're more likely to research that brand and continue researching that brand. They're more likely to tell their friends, and they're more likely to buy from that brand or become loyal. Now, this is the most powerful type of marketing that you can get. This is earned marketing, right? This is something that off of the back of your campaigns, you've now generated an additional source. And this is what your buyers trust the most. If they're referred from a friend, they themselves are more likely to go on from there. So video content is absolutely a necessary type of content that you should be considering for your channels. And when we look at some of the most successful brands out there and successful companies out there, we find that video is exactly the type of channel that they're choosing to invest in, and they're doing this right. So I want to walk through just a couple of case studies very quickly. And again, if you'd like to speak with me afterwards, I'm happy to follow up with more details. Bloomingdale's is a big retailer in the States. They have their fashion shows, they have interviews, they have the behind-the-scenes content on their web. So it's not all about product videos, it's about telling their story and getting their message out there. Bank of America, they have video portals for how-tos, for best practices, for just behind-the-scenes stories, meet and greet the staff at Bank of America. They also work with us for their intranet site, which is over six figures of employees that have access to secure content behind the scenes. We work with Puma, so all of their athletic gear. Puma has done some really interesting campaigns with us, in particular around the Olympics back in London, where they're hosting both live events that coincide with product launches and releases of products on their site. And everywhere, even continue seeing video content, even to bathrooms, right? So who would have thought that going to Kohler's website and getting not only tours of a room, but actually close-up, high-quality content of a faucet or an actual restroom? This is content that is helping them to sell their products. So we see video everywhere. And to showcase a case study that's a little bit closer to home, I do want to point out a customer, Leone. This is a manufacturing firm that has 65,000 customers around the world, and they use Brightcove to power their corporate communication, so press, analysis, et cetera. This is a Typo3 website, with thanks to our partner, Netlogix, who is a Typo3 vendor and has actually helped to build the integration today. So we're really pleased to also emphasize that working with our technology and our APIs, you can now integrate our products within the Typo3 platform. This allows Leone to actually go into the Typo3 interface, work from the interface that they are in every single day that they're most comfortable with, pull in the video content to their site without having to actually enter the Brightcove interface at all. So they can easily add and change content to their site. We thank Netlogix for building that integration today. So understanding some successful use cases, how did they get to success? So I want to talk now in terms of knowing the challenges, knowing what we recommend. What are the things that we tell our customers in order to get to a successful video strategy? Because you know, we aren't all Puma. We can't simply start with a ton of live content and an in-house production studio. Some of us have to start a lot smaller than that. So we typically say that we recommend video at every stage of the consumer life cycle, right? So everywhere from awareness and gaining a new audience all the way down to conversion, tied into the analytics of reporting. But video can be an effective channel at all stages of the customer life cycle. And we break that down into three different topics. This is a focus on awareness, engagement, and conversion. So I'm going to show you three different case studies with some additional statistics around how you get to these stages where video is implemented in the best way around these. So looking at awareness, awareness is something that we all struggle with. Right. We were recently at the content marketing conference in LA, and one of the key things that was addressed there is that the sales funnel today is dead. We no longer have a top-down funnel where people are slowly following the same buy cycle that they have over time. And I really relate to that. I believe, having come from a sales background, I really believe that we are no longer following the same trick in terms of somebody raises their hand, they go to your website, and they call you, and they follow a sales cycle. They're way ahead of us now, and we need to adjust for the fact that in order to raise awareness about our brand and our product and get attention, we need to be doing things differently. So I want to take a look at a case study we have from ExactTarget. So this is a Salesforce company. It's a marketing automation company. And they relaunched a website with us this year. We've worked very closely with their team to help them do this. But they have implemented video content throughout their entire website. They've developed an entire new portal, a video portal itself, that's extremely user-friendly. It allows you to jump into certain categories of content based on what your interests are. And then it brings you to relevant content once you've watched those. So it allows these users to navigate through a beautifully designed site that gives you the ability to know exactly what you're getting into. If you look at some of the notes here, you know, you see it's 11 videos, it's 20 videos. This sets the right expectations when you get into that specific category that you know exactly how much time this is going to take. Time is too precious for all of us. Once you see the actual video player itself, it's customized to match the look and feel of their site. There's additional related resources and related content that they showcase around this content. Just by doing this, if you get a user to click through and watch content, it's already driving them to a next step. It's already telling them that there's more to see, there's more to do. So working with them, you know, they said, when it comes to engagement, conversion, and on-brand messaging, nothing delivers like video content. And I think they've become one of our best advocates today, because the way in which they've taken content and they've embedded it throughout their entire site, to their blog posts, to their homepage, it's easy to find video content wherever you go. So is it working, right? Because all of us can start to implement video, but will it work? ExactTarget is really the best in class example, because they received over 100% increase in time on site. So they changed their average user's time from a little over 2.5 minutes to over 5 minutes just by launching this new portal. That's huge in terms of a marketer's approach in terms of what they actually want to record. They also found that they had 500 additional sales leads just from launching that video portal. They have leads that they can tie directly to a specific calls to action after tracking that or watching a video content. And they also found that they reduced the bounce rate by 12%. So this is something that is a significant increase in terms of once people reach your site, how do you keep them on your page longer? Video will allow you to do that. Now, you can download this case study as well, if you want to read all of the full story around this. But I do encourage you, more importantly, to visit their site and increase some of these stats for them too, right? But no, go ahead and visit the site. Yes?
What's the exact definition of the page bounce rate?
Bounce rate, so it's when you visit a page and then you leave that page and you go somewhere else. So you actually leave the website completely, I believe. Yeah, I see what you mean.
It's leave on
the first visit. Okay. There you go. Thank you. All right. Any other questions for ExactTarget? Okay. So let's take a look at engagement as a next case study and the next example. So Hugo Boss is also a Typo3 customer, so I'm happy to showcase them here today. We're all familiar with the brand, and we all know that if you go to their site, they have some highly interactive consumer-faced content that allows you to watch content and actually purchase from within that video content. But they came to us with a challenge that they wanted to increase awareness, in particular in the Chinese market. And every year they do a huge fashion show that they focus on just the Beijing market. It's obviously streamed globally, but the focus is to actually drive awareness from that market. Now, this is 2 years old now, but it's my favorite one that we have in terms of live streaming. I know it looks a little bit blurry, but they actually did a live stream in 3D. So they took Brightcove's platform and filmed the fashion show in 2012 in 3D, something that nobody else had done at that time. But the catch was that in order to actually watch that live stream, you needed to have 3D glasses, and not many of us have those lying around. So they had Hugo Boss branded 3D glasses that you could go and you could purchase at their store. They were advertising this through their print and digital campaigns, of course on social media, but the point is that everything allowed their consumers to actually go into the store and purchase these glasses before timing it and watching the event when it streamed live. Now, this is important because what we see and we're seeing more and more of is that our customers are bringing the physical world, so actually going in and interacting with that brand and tying that into the digital world. So they're interacting and they're crossing what we are most comfortable with now. So you now have the ability to watch that live stream from your phone, buy products from your iPad, but you've had to physically go into the store to buy those glasses. Another funny note is that they actually made a profit on selling those glasses, something they never expected. So there's a nice twist in terms of how you can actually work these promotions. And so for them, was it working? What was the results that they saw? So Hugo Boss saw an increase of 320% of their traffic around this campaign and around the live event itself. So another thing to point out about live streaming is that we recommend all of our customers do live streaming. It's easy today. There are technologies out there that allow all of our customers to live stream an event, live stream a panel, live stream an interview. It can be a small audience or a large audience, but by live streaming, it gives you the ability to attract a new set of audience. And every time you do that, it has what we call a halo effect. Viewers are going to your website, they're watching more content, and then they continue to look at other content around your site. So adding a live event once a year, once a quarter, once a week, we have customers that do live streams. It gives you the ability to drive an audience to your site and then direct them to traffic around that, increase engagement in that sense. So the next question we get in terms of engagement is you know, how long should a video be? You know, I bet if I asked anybody in this room, you'd say anywhere from 30 seconds to 2 minutes, right? Knowing our attention span is so short, we need to grab people quickly, and we want to avoid this drop-off rate. But what's funny and what we're starting to see are that a lot of our customers that are in this short form category are now even producing content that is 14 minutes long. Waitrose is a food or grocery store in the UK, and they are a key example, and I highly recommend looking at their site if you're looking for best practices. As a grocery chain, what you'll see that's different is if you look at their logo, it actually says Waitrose TV. So they are converting their brand into a television channel, and they're a grocery store. And we're seeing more and more of this today. Red Bull is the most commonly spoken about example in terms of a brand that is becoming a publisher. And a lot of our customers are now becoming publishers, whether that's it's a different term from the broadcast space, but they're creating their own TV channels and they're creating their own loyal audience that consistently goes back for more. Now, if you look at Waitrose, what they found is that if you watch any of their videos, you're not looking at a single angle of a cook who's preparing a meal. They have six different camera angles that they're seamlessly changing. They have really high quality, high definition content, and they can be up to 14 minutes long in terms of the actual setup and the prep, and their consumers are now getting used to this and they're watching this. So when we talk about performance and we talk about quality, you'll see that the amount of engagement you have will dramatically increase if it is professional content and if there is quality there. Now, going back to that, the study that I mentioned earlier, what we found to be really, to me, the most valuable piece of information that we learned is that when it comes to watching content on the web, that viewer experience and performance is the most complained about or the most demanded request that we hear from our customers. So the performance of that content is extremely, extremely important. Now, this is everything from the player load time to the quality of that content to the buffering, right? We all know what we call the spinning wheel of death, right? So what do you do when you see this little wheel come up? And what we found is that people that experience a bad viewing perception have a 62% negative perception of your brand. So if you have video content that doesn't play or that buffers or is low quality and it's a bad experience, people will actually relate that to your brand. So investing in the right video technology and streaming or delivery technology to do that is something that, yes, I'm from Brightcove, so of course I'm a little bit biased, but choosing the right platform to actually ensure that your content gets streamed and can scale with your users is something that is extremely important and worth the investment. And so lastly, I want to look at conversion and the importance of conversion, because ultimately this is what we're all trying to track and this is where we want to see the most results. So when we look at conversion, Internet Retailer has found that people that view a product, now we're just talking about product videos, are 85% more likely to buy that product than if they didn't watch a video content. I sometimes find this a little difficult to believe, but what we find is consistently when people are adding product videos, how-tos, and explanational videos about your product itself, the actual call to action, because they find this content authentic, has increased dramatically. They're more willing to buy when they can see that content. This is buying through the web, right? Because now they're no longer going into that shop. We also find that return rates are lower, because if you have how-tos and you have support videos so that people can figure out how to change the parts of your vacuum cleaner, for example, they no longer have to complain or call customer support. So there's a million benefits in which you can actually tie to the video product videos themselves. And when you look at video on a landing page, right, so this is another common use case if you're not selling products, but if you have an email blast that directs people to a landing page, or you have a campaign or a webinar, or download a white paper with a video that explains what that white paper case study is, we found that the conversion rates increased by 75%, right? So just giving people some information in terms of what they're going to actually get in touch with you about or what they're going to download increases that conversion rate. So how do you use video content to actually increase conversion, and what are some of the best practices we see? We have some unbelievable brands that use Brightcove that have interacted and actually built integrations with their products so that you can buy the product directly from the site. Customers want an easy experience. They don't want to work hard in order to buy something. So the more seamless that you can have the actual workflow, the more likely you are to drive conversion. Joyous is a brand in the US, and again, another website to look at. This company does not have any flagship stores. So they have no physical stores in which you can actually go and buy their products. Everything is done on the web, and every single product has a video to it. And what they've done is they have a presenter that actually explains and describes the product to you. She showcases that product, and then with each button, they will actually give you a very simple, clickable buy now page so that you can actually go directly from that page to purchase that product. This gives your users a seamless experience. They understand the product that they're buying, and then it becomes very easy for them to buy that content. But it also doesn't have to be products themselves. Another way of conversion is to actually upsell, right? Or to drive those users to a specific call to action, like downloading a paper. So if you look at Commonwealth Bank in Australia, around their content, they're using an out-of-the-box video template. This is no customization. You can have this up and running in 5 minutes. But really, what they've done around the page is actually given these people a call to action. Watch related content, download a paper, or call us. So conversion can also be tracked in terms of driving them to improve the actual user experience. So I just have a couple more slides, but I do want to touch on a new study that we also completed with Aberdeen Research Group. Again, you can download all of this on our site. But really, when we looked at best-in-class companies, this is all focused on who has video and who doesn't and the conversion rates around that, we found that by adding video content or content marketing within your strategy, that your conversion rate was at 4.8% versus a 2.9% for those who don't use video. I know those are all low numbers, but in the grand scheme of things, this is a really big difference by adding the video content. So I hope if you take anything away from today, it's that video moves business. Whether it's awareness, whether it's education, whether it's all the way down to conversion, there is a ton of best practices that we can offer. We'd love to talk to you about it if you have a chance. And if you remember one thing from this presentation, it's that I encourage you to leverage your Typo3 investment and the partners that you're already working with. I do want to mention how excited I am to be part of this community. We have a few partners today that we work with. Interactive Tribe is here today. They are releasing an integration that they've developed for a customer of ours that we can't talk about yet that is meant to go live in a few weeks. I've mentioned NetLogix, who has built an integration today. And AOE is here today as well, customers, the partners that we all work with. But you guys live and breathe Typo3. This is where you are familiar with working. This is the technology that you know and that you love. And to be part of that is something that we're really excited about. So would love to speak with you guys, would love to encourage you to be part of, to have Brightcove be part of that community. And I hope to hear from you guys. Thank you.
So thank you, Cassandra, for this really inspiring talk. As we are just relaunching our website, I now know I have to consider video.
Wonderful.